bring it back. From the End of Groove Remains Production Team Studios in the Netherlands. My name is Mixmaster G and welcome to this live stream. My mission is not to sell you as many apps as I can. No, my mission is to educate and teach you about collection management and conversion for DJs so you save yourself more time for the fun and creative part of being a DJ. Today we have a packed show, buddies. We really have a lot of things that we need to talk about. I received a lot of questions over in the comments and over chat because last week's stream was not that long. So we have a lot of stuff that we need to discuss. But before we dive into that, let me first say hi to the people who are there with me already in the chat. And that is Danny Doe, good to see you and happy to see you back, my friend. And AG Flow DJ, also welcome to the chat, good to see you. Now, last week, I spoke with you guys about Pioneer, who announced that they were going to release a new product each and every Tuesday. And lo and behold, today is Tuesday, and indeed, Pioneer DJ did release a new product. Let me briefly show you that. Where is my screen? There's my screen. No, that's not. This is the one I was looking for. Sorry. Go away. They introduced a white XDG XC, the XCW. For me, that is pretty underwhelming, to be honest. I don't think that releasing a new color of a product justifies all the hoopla and commotion that comes with a press release or a product release. And it takes away the attention from new releases that might be important. So I wouldn't have done it that way, but hey, I'm not Pioneer DJ, I'm just Mixmaster D from the Netherlands. But hey, here it is, the first product Pioneer DJ gave us, a white XCW. And of course, a lot of you were asking for a new XC, but the XC2, which would actually have a four-channel mixer instead of two channels that are available and two channels that need to be fed externally in order to work. But this is just the same old XZ, but then in a white finish. It is not available for all the countries. There are some limitations about it, but in my book, DJ gear needs to be black. So it's not for me, I guess. They did not release this one for me. But hey, that is the way it is. The other thing that I need to speak with you guys about is that there are a couple of things planned for the coming weeks, and let me put that on the screen as well. So let me get rid of the Pioneer release and let me hide the tractor so this all goes a little bit cleaner, like this. First of all, next week, my good friend DJ TLM will be a guest in the live stream. He will be live with me in the studio, so not over a Zoom call or something. No, he will be actually here in the ATGR studio, and the both of us will answer on every questions you guys may have. So please buckle up and ask those questions in advance so we can go in depth in them. Then Saturday, May the 28th, there is an event at the Box Shop in Goes. Box Shop is one of the biggest music gear retailers in the Netherlands. I am there at what is called Open Dag, Open House. I will have my own demonstration area. I will give a masterclass there. It will all be in Dutch, but if you happen to be Dutch like me, and you are in the neighborhood, then come by, stop by. At least you can pick up one of these, which is still the most fun coaster you can get as a DJ, namely cup coasters in the form of vinyl. And I will give them those away. So just make sure that you join me there. That was happening as well. Another thing that is happening is that I released a couple of short videos. It's a little thing I am experimenting with. I'm still not sure where it will take me, but I decided that some of the questions keep coming back, not only for me, but on Reddit, where I'm often am, or on Facebook in the groups I follow. I see the same question over and over again, so I decided to make a couple of short videos how certain things can be done. Those shorts are in the YouTube channel, and if you join or if you go to the YouTube channel, you will automatically find them. There is a short now how you can transfer all the data and music and collection data, everything that is on an old Mac to a new Mac, and there are actually two videos for that. If the new Mac is a brand new out of the box Mac, never used, then the procedure is slightly different from when a new Mac has actually already a user account and some data on it. So that is why I made two videos, to make sure that it is clear which one is which. And there I show you and I demonstrate you how you can do this stuff. We can transfer everything from one old computer to a new computer, or maybe two old computers, I don't care. But how you can transfer data the easy way. It is centered around my famous workflow, external drive, Karma Copy Cloner to Karma Copy Clone the old data, and then on the new computer, Apple's Migration Assistant that is free with every macOS that is installed. So you can automatically find that, and I really highly recommend it. Another short I made is the number one problem when DJs are preparing a CDJ USB from Rekordbox and they forget to add Rekordbox to the full access pane, the system preferences full access, and that is really a number one problem. So I made a short about it. I've got more ideas for shorts in the future, so stay tuned for that. And please let me know what you think about those shorts, or if you have a subject that is worthy of a short, let me know. I'm happy to demonstrate that as well, or to dive into it as well. So hey, feedback is always appreciated, folks. And then there are some things that I released. First of all, I released an update to the Denon Extractor tool. The Denon Extractor tool is the tool that comes with the Denon Conversion Utility. It's bundled. When you buy the Denon Conversion Utility, you get the Denon Extractor tool as well. And the Denon Extractor tool makes it possible to go from Engine DJ to Rekordbox. So the other way around, from the Denon Conversion Utility, you can go with the Denon Extractor tool from Engine DJ to Rekordbox. And what's new in this update is that the playlist order is maintained. And maybe if I show it to you, you understand it, because showing is always believing, right? So let's do a little tour here and let's... No, I don't want to quit Chrome, because then I miss everything that is important today. Let me fire up Engine DJ. And let's just clear it out, just to make sure that there is nothing there. Remove from the collection and remove this one from the collection. And let's make a new playlist. Let's call it Test Engine DJ, like this. And drop some test tracks in it. And analyze those tracks, because you need to analyze those tracks. And then let's mangle the order a little bit. So let's put... hold on, I just need one. I don't need all of them. Somehow it's fighting me today, but why is that? That's weird. Engine DJ all of a sudden decides that it doesn't allow me to order my playlist. But now it does. My bad. All right, so we put Einstein on top of it. And we put Ghost Town as the last track, so and everything in between. And what's new with the Denon Extractor tool is that that particular order is maintained. Don't back up, come on. Let me show that to you guys. Let's fire up the Denon Extractor tool. I'm not sure if I gave it all permissions. No, not yet. It always helps to kind of prepare these kind of these streams, so we know that everything is smooth and running. But hey, this is me. I'm updating and changing stuff all the day long on my computer, so sometimes things are not as prepared as I like them to be, but hey, we'll survive. Now let me put the backup drive away, so at least the finding of the Rekordbox collections takes a little less time, because otherwise this can take forever. Not forever, but it can take a long time. By the way, folks, don't forget, if you've got questions or if things are not clear, ask them in the chat. That is the chat. That's what the chat is for. I am watching. That's weird. Hold on, folks. This is weird, because now I get a message that X26 most likely is not installed. So let me double check that. If you've got a question, drop it in the chat, because I am here to answer all and every questions. I know what to do. Go on. And let's see, where I invoke X26 after conversion. Let me quickly check if this is a minor one or if this is a big one. Because if this is a big one, then I'm not going to do this. But we'll see that in a moment. Oh, okay. Fair point. There is no Rekordbox database. Oh, I love it if my apps are smarter than I am. Do you want to hear? Yes. That is really a smart one. I forgot entirely about it. Let me tell you what happened. Last time I used Rekordbox, I most likely moved the database to a different computer or a different drive. Now the master database is not available, which means that I couldn't use it. And that was exactly what you saw, and that was why X26 refused to set up because it said, hey, listen, I cannot find that master database and I need access to it. Pamela N, short answer, no. Slightly longer answer, if you can MIDI map it, yes. You can look at the Tractor Bible to see if maybe there is a MIDI map already available for that particular controller. Rekordbox with Tractor. Now that you can forget. That you can forget altogether. Rekordbox only works with Pioneer DJ controllers, period. So forget it. Won't fly. However, you can... That was a first, folks. I accidentally quitted OBS. That was a first for me. Pamela Ann, no, you cannot. But you can, of course, convert your Rekordbox collection to Tractor and then use that controller with Tractor. And if you are lucky, then that Tractor unlocks, or that controller unlocks Tractor. So that will be the smarter way, maybe. Let me go back to where I was at. I was at the Denon Extractor tool, the updated Denon Extractor tool. We created an Engine DJ playlist that was in a particular order. And now I'm going to convert that playlist to Rekordbox. Like I said, Pamela, and you can do this kind of stuff also from Rekordbox to Tractor. And I thought I did eject that drive. No, I didn't eject it. All right, that's my bad. That's entirely on me that we have to wait for this to finish. There we are. That's more like it. No warnings. But at least I still know that the warning system is in place and works, which is in itself something that I can work with. All right, I'm going to use the Engine DJ collection on the internal drive. Just say OK and select the playlist I just created. And this is a pretty quick conversion, as you can see. And now X26 will pick it up and eject all the data into Rekordbox, which is basically automatic now. And it would be nice if X26 showed its user interface. Ah, there it is. And then Rekordbox will open and you will see that we have that playlist that I created in that particular order. For some DJs, it is a big deal. I had several requests for this. That's why I made it. For me personally, it is not that big of a thing. I really don't mind. You can see, if we go to the... why not? Where is my hashtag column? Oh, there it is. It's all the way... boy, but it was already sorted properly, as you can see. Let me put that here. And then you can see that Einstein is the first one, Ghost Town is the last one. And if we compare that with the Engine DJ playlist, you'll see that those two are identical, which was exactly what we wanted to have. See? So that is a little trick that I added to the Denon Extractor tool. Of course, the Denon Extractor tool also converts your cues, your loops, and everything else. So, it is... Why is everything fighting me today? This one. Still, it seems to work. So, that was updated. I did a minor update, for those of you interested, to the Tractor iTunes Merge Playlist tool, TIMP. TIMP is a tool that takes an iTunes or Apple Music playlist or a collection, and then you can select which playlist you want to see in Tractor. The reason for that is that the way Tractor handles those integrations is not very good. So that is why I wrote my own app for it, and I did put a minor update on it. Thing is, TIMP doesn't have its auto update system, which means you need to update TCK in order to get the latest version. But don't forget, there is always a way to go through Selfie and to download the latest version of all the apps that you have bought. There's a tutorial for that in the YouTube channel. If you don't know, how to do it. Tito Mortales, salute, good to see you, my friend. And that brings us to the first big subject of today, the large subject of today, the thing that we are going to dive into. I got this question from a fellow tractor user named Ola Johnson. And Ola, and let me put it in the chat and see if I can make it on screen. I can do that. Can I then make it on screen? Yeah, all right, but then it will kind of cut it off. But the question Ola had is basically, I have all my tracks on an external drive and I have two computers. If I go from one computer to another computer, can I make my tractor collections sync with each other? And the answer to that is yes, you can. And it's actually not syncing what we are going to do. What we are going to do is we are going to put the tractor collection on that external as well. And then I will show you that indeed you can do all kind of funny stuff on another computer. So the question is, hey, all the tracks on an external drive, how can I sync everything with two different computers? By the way, those two computers need to be Apple Macintosh computers. That is important because this won't work between Windows and Tractor unless you are going to do some other complex stuff. You can try to relocate tracks in Tractor, but that might be part for a different tutorial or a different stream. We are going to do this. No, do not ask me, and not now. Why is that thing running again? Let me quit it. I really hate it if stuff is all of a sudden going to run without my permission. Let's format the clutch drive, and because I'm going between Apple Macintosh computers, we can format it Macintosh native. So let's take macOS Extended Journal, which is the base Macintosh formatting. On a kite partitioning scheme, an air between them makes it more beautiful. So there we go. And we now have an external drive that is empty. I'm going to throw the test tracks on it. So there are test tracks on it. And I'm going to fire up my tractor collection, which is still open. Let's create a playlist. Create a playlist and we call this test one. Why not? Let's be original, right? Put the test tracks in it. Let's analyze them. Now, the problem is, of course, the moment I take away this drive, Tractor doesn't know about playlists, etc., because Tractor uses a central database, much like a Rekordbox or a Virtual DJ does. So what I need to do is I need to put the information from Tractor on that clutch drive as well. How do I do that? Now, that is simple. You go to your documents folder. Let me open and empty. And within documents, there is a folder named Native Instruments. And within Native Instruments, let me close them all a little bit, there is a Tractor folder. That Tractor folder will have your current Tractor version number as a name as well. So the folder Tractor 353. That folder contains everything Tractor related, the collection, the playlist, the analysis data, the artwork, everything. So I'm going to put that on my clutch drive. And next I need to do is I tell Tractor not to use the old Tractor database, but the new Tractor database. If you go to the preferences of Tractor and you go to the file management and you go to the root dir, there you can define where Tractor finds all its data. And that is that particular folder. So we choose that particular folder. That means that you have to restart Tractor. Let's restart now. And then what I always do to make sure that I know what I'm doing is I rename that Tractor, that old Tractor folder in the documents folder to old Tractor. That makes sure, because that way Tractor will warn me if it can't find its data. Otherwise, things can get confusing because right now both those Tractor collections are identical. So I wouldn't know that I wasn't working in the internally stored collection. So what I always do is I disable it by this, and then I will show that as well. If I fire up Traktor, by the way, right now it will work as normal because we already taught it to use the data on the Prutz drive. So we have test one here and we have the tracks there. Now here's the trick. And that's the reason why I renamed that folder. If I start Traktor yet again, it will tell me, hey, I couldn't initialize. And then you know, all right, I forgot to mount the drive that everything is on. Or maybe my root there is set wrong. So this, I use that as a warning. I used it as a warning method, and now it will create its default playlist, and then you know, all right, I am in trouble. So there's a reason that I always rename the old one. And I've got, of course, this drive right here. And I'm going to walk up to my Mac Mini, connect it, come back to you, and then show you that indeed we can now share one Traktor collection between two computers, and those will stay 100% in sync. So let me walk up there. I thought I already made that. That's weird. I'm missing some of my shortcuts. But hey, you can see me walk up there. No problem. And let's walk back. That's one of the benefits of wearing a wireless microphone. At least you can still hear me if I'm walking back and forth. And you can see there is now default in my Traktor, but we will fix that later on. Let's quit Traktor on the main computer and let's TeamViewer into the other computer, in the Mac Mini, and show you what this is all about. There we are at the Mac Mini, and let me make this a little bit smaller. Let's fire up Traktor there, and you will see that right now nothing has changed because I didn't change the database. You can see this is the default Traktor collection that is there when you buy Traktor. So let's go again to the preferences, and then let's find the file management preferences. Go to the root there and set it to the Prutz drive, to this one, to that one. Restart Traktor. Somehow you have to start Traktor again. If you say restart, it will quit, but it will not automatically. No. And then it asks me for the default music, and we take the Prutz drive for the default music. That's fine. And there we are, and there you can see that the test playlist is indeed there, and the tracks are there, and everything will load because, hey, the file path to the tracks is all the same. So let's create, just to show you how powerful this functionality is. Let's create a new playlist, call it Test 2 on Mac Mini. And then just add some tracks to it, why not? And let's load one track and give it a cue. It already got a cue. Let's give it a third cue. So it got a cue right there. Let's quit Traktor here. Let's eject the Prutz drive, and then I have to pick it up, of course. Because otherwise you cannot see the results on the main computer. And here I am again with my Prutz drive. Let me switch the screen. Let me connect the Prutz drive. I can quit TeamViewer here because that is no longer necessary. And then fire up Traktor. Of course, I need to set the root drive again because it forgot that, but we can set it again. Go to file management, the root there, point it to the Prutz drive, tractor folder, that folder there, just the folder, then it will find everything, automatically restart now. And let's fire up tractor once again. And there you can see that both playlists are indeed there. And if you load that track, you can see that that third queue is indeed also set. So this is how you can make your entire tractor collection portable using an external drive. And this was actually what Ola was asking. So Ola, here you go, buddy. This is how you do it. Then the other question is actually are two questions around the same theme. The theme is creating a CDJ USB, and the problem that one of the people had is, let's see if I can post it again, but I see that they are abbreviated. Erik Leure had, I hope I pronounced that right, by the way. Let me post it in the chat. There it is. Erik Leure had had a question. If you want to see more columns on a Nexus 2 CDJ, and unfortunately these are CDJ 3000, which means that the screen is bigger and there is more information on the screen. But the Nexus 2 CDJ and everything before that has a very limited screen, has a very small screen. That means that usually the title of the track is shown and something else. But Eric wants that something else to be both the BPM and the key information, and that is not possible. But there is a solution for that. If you look at the, let me fire a bracket box and let's create first a collection there. And then I have, all right. Yes, let's do that first and then I go to the other question separate from this. So first let's go into how you can get the key and BPM in the same field together on your screen. And that are we going to do right here. This was the one I was looking for. I wanted to turn that one off. All right, here we have a record box collection, and let me take everything out of it because this was from the test we run with the extractor tool earlier on. By the way, just a tip, you just saw me doing it. If you very quickly want to remove all kind of playlists, just put them all in a folder and remove that folder. That's much quicker than do it one by one by one. So I always, if I know I have to delete a lot, then I just gather it all in a big folder, playlist folder, and then throw away that folder. Goes much faster. Let me put some tracks on it. Let me. There we go. And if you look at the comment field, then you can already see what I wanted to show you guys. Those comments are created by, in my case, the Tractor Queue and Key tool, but we have also the Recordbox Queue and Key tool. Both of those tools take mixed in key data, take the analysis from mixed in key, and combine that with the grid data from either Recordbox or Tractor to create sortable comments. If you look at this comment field, I can click on comment and then you can see it is sorted, and it is sorted the right way because if a key is below 10, there will be a zero in front of it. And if a BPM is below 100, there will also be a zero in front of it. So that will be sorted correctly. If that weren't the case, then 10 would be before 5 because the 1 would be the biggest sorting criterion. So that is that. Comment fields created by either Recordbox Queue & Key tool with the aid of mixed in key data, or if you convert from Tractor Queue & Key tool, and again, mixed in key data and Tractor beat grids or Recordbox beat grids. The BPM is by default coming from the base DJ software because I'm not very fond of the analysis, the BPM analysis of Recordbox or for a mixed in key. Recordbox and Tractor are better in my opinion, but you can always go for mixed in key BPM if you would like that. And then those will become sortable. And That means that you need that command field next to your CDJ USB, and that is where the real fun begins. First of all, let me format my Prutz drive as a FAT drive. I know on my CDJ 3000s it will even work as an XFAT or as a macOS extended, but just because I always say to people, listen, if you are going to spin CDJs and if you have no idea what CDJ you are going to spin, then I highly recommend you to at least make it FAT, because FAT can be read by every CDJ out there, and that is the reason why I always advocate that. So let's take the Prutz drive, let's erase it, and this time we go for the master boot record, and we want it to be FAT, and we call it Prutz because that is the name it always has. Okay, back to my record box collection, and now things are going to get interesting, Eric, because by default commands are not on the CDJ USB, they are not exported, and by default you cannot see it, let alone sort on it. There is a way to make that possible. If you go in Recordbox to preferences and you go to your DJ system and you go to the device column, I always have to find where that stuff is hidden. That is correct. Then we go to Hotkey, that is correct. Here are my settings, the my settings I want to be at. And we go to player and we go to DJ settings. These are my default DJ settings, and they are not the default ones that are in Recordbox, but hey, this is the way they are looking. Now if you go to display and display indicator, let me double check this all, if this is okay. And I want the jog brightness to be dark, I want this to be dark, and I want this to be on one. I always wanted the LCD to be as low as possible because of the cam. So that is the reason why I make them low. In a moment I want to show you the results on the CDJ, and that means that those need to be low. So right now they are set to low, so that is a good thing. Now if I go to my Prutz drive and I go to my settings again, then I can double check that indeed those settings are now stored there, but they should already be stored. You can see that's on dark, so that's already taken. Now here is the interesting part. First, the sort part. I told you we want commands to be the default sort column. That means that you take the commands, you highlight them in the left column, then click the red arrow so they go to the right, then click them and move them up all the way, which means commands is at the top of your sorting right now. Then we can say in column, and that will tell us what will be shown on the CDJ the moment we load track. And you can, of course, say comments. So by these two settings, you make it possible to at least see your key and your BPM, because those are stored in my comments. And you can sort on key and BPM to very quickly find compatible songs, because that is sortable. Let me put this playlist on it like this. We have to wait for it to finish. And of course, if you are on FAT, that will always be slower. macOS Extended is way faster in syncing than a FAT drive is, but let's just wait for it. And of course, again, folks, if you've got questions for me, drop them in the chat. So that means that I can pick them up after we finish this one. Because after all, that is what we are doing here, answering questions that come in. I can eject the Prutz drive right here, and I can go to the overhead cam and I didn't take a cable with me, I think, or is this a USB 3 cable, I think. Let's see. Cables are always, but I bet you all know that cables are always a little bit of an issue around the studio, but hey, we are good. I got the cable here. So if I connect this, we say in source, waiting for the drive to load this drive, You can see right here a My Settings Load. First I'm going to press that. That means that my settings are loaded in the player, and that means that all those things that we just changed are already there. So if I go to my playlist and if I load the track, then I can see that comments are indeed, I hope it's visible on the cam, folks. Comments are, is indeed the default selection criterion, and I can just sort on it, load the track, and that makes navigation a whole lot easier, of course. And there it is already with everything on it. So this is how you prepare your CDJ USB to make sure that you can see the key and BPM and use them as a criterion to select the next track, which makes, of course, life a whole lot easier. Because otherwise, well, you are kind of lost and you cannot see exactly what's going on. But like I said, because this is CDJ 3000, I have more than one column to show. I can even scroll. No, I cannot scroll. But at least I can see those columns. So I could say BPM, and let's do that. Let's do a little test here to make things a little bit easier. Always eject your drive, folks. Let's hook it up. Let's switch the screen. And let's go to the Prutz drive. And then in the sort, I want comments and I want rating as next. Let's see if that will automatically take it. I don't want the album, I couldn't care less. BPM I've got in the comments, key I've got in the comments, an artist should be there as well. That's that one, that's that one. No, what I was trying to look for, if I'm able, active categories, I don't know. If I was able to tell the CDJ to show the ratings next to the comments, that would be dope, but I guess that's not possible. But I did change this, so let's see if that those changes make it over to the CDJ. If we connect it up. I forgot to load the settings, but now they are loaded. Go to the playlist. No, it's still BPM key that is next to the comments. So you cannot change that, unfortunately, but hey, it is a lot better than not having that information at all. And on Nexus 2, of course, that is more compressed because the screen is smaller, so you cannot do that. Then the last question we had from Joteo. Joteo is using the DJ conversion utility. He has Serato as his main collection database, and he is using iTunes or the music app, I'm not sure on what Mac OS Joe is, as his base collection manager, exactly as I always advocate. And he's asking me, is there a smart way to sync between Serato and Rekordbox? Making sure that you don't have to do everything, but only the tracks that are changed in one of them. And indeed, Joe, there is such a way, and let me show that way. First of all, let me post the question and let's see if it will. No, that is cut off, but all right, we leave that on for a little bit. Let me do some preparations here because I want to make sure that Serato doesn't try to load its, that is off, that's good. All right, then we are good to go, I guess. We put that off, and we go to the screen, and we fire up Serato. I want to make sure that it's not loading everything from, there we are, from the file server. All right, let's create a crate named Test Serato. Oh no, we want to do this from iTunes. That's right. We want to do this from iTunes, so we don't have any crates in Serato at all. Let me quit Serato here, and let me quickly create in iTunes playlist one. No, that can all go. Delete. Go away. I choose once to do something that I don't want it to do, so. Let's force quit it and let's fire it up again. This one can go away, delete. That one can go away, that one can go away, that can go away. Let's create a new playlist. Test shared playlist. Just as a test, not much to it. And let's take. Some of the tracks. Let me double check that my preferences are set the way I want them to be. Yes, they are set the way I want them to be, because otherwise this becomes a mess. And let's make sure that my view is as songs, because this is how I like to see my iTunes playlists. So I have this test shared iTunes playlist, and let's fire up Serato. And let's make sure that we can see iTunes, which means that in the library we need to show the iTunes library. There it is. There's the test shared playlist. And let's take the David Guetta track. Why not? The David Guetta track, and let's give it a cue. A random cue. And that's it for now. Why not? Let's give it a loop, but I need to talk about cues and loops later on. So we gave the David Guetta track a cue. The other tracks I'm not messing around with. I'm not using the other tracks. So I only worked with one track, that is the David Guetta track. Let's quit Serato here. Oh, there was something I needed to double check. Let me double check that. Hold on, folks. I want to double check that my Serato collection is empty. All songs? No, it's not empty, so let's take that away. And then the David Guetta track is still there. All right, we can quit this. And then in the DJ conversion utility, usually the DJ conversion utility is lit up by crates if you go from Serato to Rekordbox, or playlists if you go from Traktor to Rekordbox, or playlists if you go from Rekordbox to something else. Now I'm going to use a different method to select the tracks I want to convert. I'm going to use the modification date selection. If I fire up the DJ conversion utility with this conversion, it will tell me that there are no crates found, because it cannot find any crates unless I forgot something. And there it is already. No Serato crates found. So that is useless. Now, I could, if I wanted to. Why is X26 still active? Oh, that's just fired up. If I wanted to, I could create a crate with just the tracks I want to convert. This is, by the way, still the stuff from Dext that X26 is picking up now. That wasn't really what I wanted, but hey, it is what it is. Let's fire up the DJ conversion utility once again after X26 is stopped. Let's stop Rekordbox here. Sorry, folks, it's a little bit more complicated than I wanted, but all I wanted to show you is the DJ conversion utility will tell you that there are no crates, but we already knew that. So what I will do right now is I will use the date modified as a selection criterion, and we take today's date because I just added those tracks to Serato. So, and ideally it will only convert that single David Guetta track, but we will see. So first of all, select only tracks modified at or after, and the date of today is already there, and we can just tell it to go ahead. And this time you see there is no warning. And there is no playlist selection, because there are no playlists or crates. There are just tracks that meet that criterion. are converted and everything else is not converted. That's weird. It tells us now that you cannot found any of the tracks, which should be found, but I'm not entirely sure what's up here, folks. But I'm sure it is explained. Well, let me go to to record box, just import it manually. That always works, unless those tracks are not there. There are no tracks at all. That is weird. There should be at least one track. Let me double check that indeed that track is now in Serato as well, because that is the whole point of this demonstration. And let me just make sure that that is working and that I can play it for a moment, because then it should at least go to the... But it might be possible that my... To double check that. Might be possible that my V2 database, through all the deleting and other stuff I did, is damaged. Or it might be possible that it had... I didn't double check that. That the date edit is a different one. That is also entirely possible. So let me double check that as well. Where is the track that I was using? David Guetta I was using. There it is. And let me give it an extra cue like this. And then let's quit it. And see what happens if this time around we use the modification date selection criterion. Like I said, sometimes it pays off to prepare this kind of stuff, but it still should work in the long end. But it might be a defective database of Serato, which of course I made defective myself. Let me first see what happens if I do this. And there is always our friend, the log file, to tell us what's going on. Ah, now it finds the converted file, so now we are going to be fine. Don't you love it if you know your shit? There we go. Problem was that it wasn't played and it wasn't analyzed and I didn't give it an extra cue, so stuff like that was the problem. X26 is finished, Recordbox is started up as you can see, and now you've got under the selected Serato crates, you have a playlist created. Only this, that only contains that single track. Now let me show you the trick. If we go to iTunes, we go to the playlists, and we need to make sure that iTunes is using the correct iTunes XML. Let's double make sure that indeed it is. Inside iTunes, there we are today, and there we need the XML today, that's the one. And if I load that track from iTunes, then you can see indeed that it has the queues and it is loaded from iTunes. So the date modified, the selection criterion date modified, is the thing you want to use, Joe, if you want to convert only tracks that you played with after a given date. Same if you added tracks, if you did other tracks, but for that to see the difference, I need to have an older collection so you can see the difference. And these tracks were all only added today, but you can see that if I do Kungs, if I only take the Kungs track and give it some cues in Serato, and do the same thing again, then that Kungs track will also be converted, but the rest will not be converted. So that is a huge time saver. So let's load it up. Let's make sure that it's analyzed. Let's give it a cue there, and let's give it a cue there. and then let's quit it like this. And then let's fire up the DJ conversion utility. And by the way, folks, these exact same selection criterions are available for Traktor users as well. It is what I use in my workflow, and you can watch the workflow tutorial or my entire workflow. Actually, it's a live stream in the YouTube channel. It is there for you to watch, and then you can see how I use it with Traktor. And I will show you, if you want to go the other way around, from Rekordbox to, let's say, Serato, how that works as well. But we do that in a moment. So first, let's do it like this. That is all fine. Let's go. And let's wait for it to happen. And by the way, folks, if you've got questions, DJ related questions, throw them in the chat. I will be happy to address them, to see what I can do with them, to demonstrate them, to answer them. But then you really need to put those questions in the chat. Otherwise, I wouldn't know. And this is the last subject that I had in advance that I was going to talk about. So after this, I will close the chat unless there are other questions or things that are not entirely clear. Because, hey, that's what I try to do here, to make things a little bit more clear. So let's go to direct to the iTunes part. And it is, again, not loading the correct iTunes playlist. I don't know why it's doing that, but that's weird. It's not picking up my iTunes playlist at all. The wonderful world of Rekordbox. Is the one I want to use. That is a valid iTunes playlist. There it is, finally. It was about time, right? Kungs is not analyzed, but if I load it up, and it has not been modified. Not sure, it still must be a thing. Oh, I didn't play it. My bad. I needed to play it a little bit to make sure that it would end up in the V2 database. So I didn't play it, and therefore there is nothing there. My bad again, but hey, trust me, if I had played it, then it would have been there. So that is that. For those of you who are on Rekordbox and want to use date modification as a selection criterion as well, it is possible. It is possible, but not by default. With all my conversion tools, there comes an app named Rekordbox 6 to XML. And if you start up that app holding down the Alt or the Option key on your keyboard, something funny happens. Because it will ask you which modification date you want to use. And then you can say, all right, I want to only have the tracks that were added at or after today, May 17th. And then it will create an XML that only contains those particular tracks that meet that criterion. And then, of course, you can convert to Serato, and you can still use both programs to use a playlist. So that can be very, very helpful as well. Again, it's not very illustrative in this example because the entire Rekordbox collection was created today, so everything is modification day to day. But if you have a huge Rekordbox collection, then it can be very powerful to use the date modified as your selection criterion. But that still means that you need to use one single playlist, or that means that you need to use iTunes or the music app as your collection manager to create all your playlists and etc. Because otherwise it will not work. You cannot do that. You can only do it if you make your playlists in iTunes, because you just get a flat playlist out of it with only the tracks that meet the criterion. That also brings me to the end of tonight's live stream, unless anybody got a question for me, and then I'm happy to address that question. Just throw it in the chat and let me scroll back to see that I didn't miss anything, but it looks like I'm all good there. Before I leave you, let me remind you guys that next week we will have DJ TLM in the studio, the one and only, and we will talk all things DJ together. And of course, we are here to answer each and all of your questions that is DJ related. So I hope to see you guys back then. May 28th, Bax Open Dag in Goes for the Dutch people amongst us. Come and meet me there. Happy to see you there. And of course, stay tuned on the Facebook and YouTube channel for new shorts that I have planned and that I will release in the upcoming weeks. If you like what I'm doing, then don't forget to give this video the thumbs up, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and I hope to see you guys, all you guys, next week with my friend DJ TLM, straight from the ATGR production team studios. For now, Mixmaster G, signing off.